you must have already heard about the Internet of Things. Analysts foresee a dramatic increase in the number of connected devices, going up to 30 billion in 2020 and possibly millions of sensors per kilometer square. The application covers a very large variety of devices such as connected cars, home appliances, personal objects, and this predicted huge number of sensors collecting various types of information. You can think of cameras, presence detectors, temperature measurements, or biomedical sensors, and so on. Because of this very large increase both in numbers and variety, researchers are looking for a new and flexible way of transmitting the information to allow all these connections to coexist efficiently. With that in mind, we at ICT have been looking at a waveform design called FBMC for filter bank multicarrier. In a multicarrier transmission, the total available bandwidth, the frequencies, are split between the different connections. Each device is using a part of the bandwidth depending on its data rate needs. And the larger the band, the higher the data rate. But there is a limitation, however, due to the fact that all transmission waveforms create interference on the frequencies that are next to the main band they are using. And depending on the choice of the waveform, this interference can extend on a smaller or on a larger range. And then the different devices may be able to transmit on frequencies that are close to each other, or on the contrary, may have to be spaced further apart, and in that case, you lose a large part of the bandwidth. To solve that issue, many current systems, like 4G or some Wi-Fi versions, are using a waveform design called OFDM that is able to remove this interference, even when the different devices are connected within close frequencies. But this is only possible when the devices are connected to the same base stations, and they also need to be synchronized in some way. So this is fine for a system like 4G, where all the users that are close to each other are connected to the same base station. But with the foreseen increase in the number of devices and the diversification of the standards that could transmit within the same frequency without any synchronization, it becomes very important to take into account this interference to other systems. This is why the design of the waveform is so crucial. The particular case of FBMC that we have studied is optimized to reduce as much as possible the interference it creates on the adjacent frequencies. Hence, it enables to pack the different connections as close as possible in frequency and use the total bandwidth as efficiently as possible. Now, this new waveform design is not completely new. It has been proposed more than 20 years ago. So, what was our contribution in this field? Well, I have mostly talked about the advantages of the waveforms, but there are also some disadvantages. In particular, the waveform is quite sensitive to some effects that can occur during the transmission. For instance, multipath propagation or Doppler effects can distort the signal, and that would degrade the recovery of information at the receiver. Fortunately, it is possible to compensate for this distortion, and we have worked on various ways to automatically measure and then cancel out some of these effects. In particular, we have deeply analyzed the case where multiple antennas are used at the transmitter and possibly at the receiver. In that case, the distortion can become even more problematic, but there are also more degrees of freedom to cancel it out. So we have designed some simple yet very efficient precoders that are able to take care of the distortion. This doesn't stop here, however. The same waveform is currently considered for other communication systems, like power line communications, optical fiber communications, or cognitive radio applications. We at ICT team are convinced that this type of waveform has strong benefits and could be a very good candidate for future communication standards. If you are interested to know more, don't hesitate to contact us.